advice and everything nice.
Hey, what's up, you guys? Michelle here. Let me put the radio down. Welcome back to my channel. Welcome back to another, I guess, weight loss vlog. I don't want to call it like a regular vlog because it's like mostly focused on like my weight loss journey-ish. You guys already know the deal. I don't really know what to call it, so we're going to call it weight loss vlog slash like Trader Joe's haul. I just came back from Trader Joe's. I got a whole bunch of goodies. I've been dying to go to Trader Joe's. I haven't been in a minute, so I was like, you know what? I don't really have big plans for today. And there's been a lot of cool new things at Trader Joe's, and it's pretty cheap. So I was like, let me just take a little road trip. Today I actually picked up my mom from Colombia, so actually I've been pretty out and about today. But yeah, today's Tuesday, June 8th. How's everybody doing? The last time I saw you guys was actually for my Memorial Day weekend vlog from SMF and Skyline in Tampa and Orlando, which was so much fun. Honestly, I did get the post-festival blues a little bit because I had a blast. When I came back, I didn't. I was like, oh, I don't think I'm gonna get the post-festival blues because I was just so tired and I had a super, super bad period. But when my period left, everything like hit me at once and I was like, oh my God, like I really do miss it. Like I just had so much freaking fun and now it's like all over and back to normal and it's all like, nah, kind of sucks. But this weekend is Forbidden Kingdom in Orlando. I don't think I'm gonna go as much as I would like to go. Unfortunately, I've had to spend a lot of money this weekend in getting my car open. You guys saw in my last vlog, someone tried to break into my car and fucked up my entire keyhole. My car key to unlock the car wasn't working. I bought new batteries for it. It still didn't work. I don't know why it just stopped working all of a sudden. I don't know if it has to do with something with the door, the sensor or something for the door. So I had to get a locksmith to open my car, which was $200. Not only that, but my car also ran out of battery and the battery's been fucked up for a bit now, which is also kind of weird. So I had to get a brand new battery as well. So you know when life just throws you like those random inconveniences, is that what you want to say? Like there's not really much that I can do. Like you have to pay for it, you have to do what you have to do. This weekend I didn't really do much. I wasn't planning on really doing anything this weekend, to be honest, but I did end up going out last minute to watch the Logan Paul Mayweather fight with some friends and ended up having a really, really good night, a really fun, funny night. I ended up staying over at my friend's house, like on her couch, because I just could not drive home. I had a blast. It was like a nice little girl's day. We went out, we saw the fight, and then we went back to her house. We had some glasses of wine and talked about everything with, you know, like with the girls. Like there was laughs, there was tears, it was great. And then I just fell asleep and it was amazing. This weekend I actually planned out my week on paper with highlighters and pens. They made it all cute. As of recently, I've been a very go with the flow person, I'd say for the past year already, and I haven't really moved forward, and I'll be completely honest when it comes to that. I feel like I've been very comfortable, very neutral, but I haven't really been moving forward. And I talk about 2019 a lot because I'm just so stuck on it, but I know I have to move on because obviously we can't go backwards, we can only go forward. But I always reference to that year because that was the year where I really feel like I had my shit together. And I feel like since moving out of my house, getting my shit together, and then going through a breakup and moving back into my house, and then kind of like going through, you know when you, the breakup phases, I don't really have to talk about it, but you guys know there's breakup phases, and you know I've been through all of them, and mostly the party stage one, and I've just been, you know, having a good time and not really focusing on the things that I should be focusing on. And I think it's kind of hitting me hard now, and I kind of realize that I just don't really feel fulfilled in my life right now, and I feel like I need to do more for myself, and I feel like I don't really feel fulfilled even really with friendships and even with work, like my job. I don't really feel like I have a passion for anything. I don't know, I don't have anything that makes me really want to wake up and do something, you know? Like I just wake up and it's just kind of like this neutral thing, and I just want to find passion and love into something. Well, actually no, recently I've been super focused on wanting to start my podcast, but I have to find a space to film my podcast, I have to buy the equipment for the podcast, and it is a little expensive. I just want everything to be perfect. I have to, you know, start making more money. I also want to focus on moving out. Like there's a lot of things in mind, and this weekend I kind of like really thought about everything and just decided to plan things and be more organized about everything. I feel like I put everything to the side, or I'll say like I'll do it some other day and I always forget. So I wrote everything down. I planned everything and I got to work this week and just kind of like reflected in myself and told myself, okay, how are we going to move forward? What are the things we're going to do? What's our plan? You know, be more responsible about things. I'm not going to say I'm going to stop going out completely and all that, because let's be realistic. It's really hard for some people to understand, but I'm a person who loves human interaction. That's one of the things that I miss the most about having a job is the human interaction and making friends at work and making friends from like customers or clients or whatever it is that where you work at. And when you're at home all the time by yourself and you don't have any human interaction, the only human interaction I get is from when I go out. So it is a little hard to want to stop going out, because it was a lot easier when I used to work, because I would have human interaction when I was at work. And then by the time I get home, I'm like, I don't want to have any more human interaction. But now since I'm always at home, ever since I did leave my job, that's been probably the hardest thing, is just like being bored and wanting to interact and like talk to people, and also just being in my house all the time with my parents and my brother. Like, I love my family to death, and I'm very grateful for everything they've given me. But I think it's just, you know, it's just been really hard ever since I moved out and then moved back in a few months. And I just am in such a point in my life where I just kind of, not that I want to be alone, but like I wish that I can just be in an apartment and be by myself, adopt a pet, and just like do my YouTube and my OF content, do my podcast, and just all in my own time and feel comfortable. And just, I feel like that's what I really want to focus on, is just having my own place to be able to move forward, because I 1000% know that I would be more successful if I just had my own place. So right now my main focus is just trying to save as much money as I can to be able to move out pretty soon. And my parents are so amazing that they understand 100%, because they see the struggle sometimes of when I'm trying to film or do things around the house, and they can help themselves because they also live there as well. They all try to accommodate and help me out as much as they can, but obviously sometimes we do clash. But my parents did say that they would help me out whenever I do choose to be ready to move out. So yeah, and I didn't want to make this intro so long. I wanted this to be mostly a Trader Joe's haul, but I feel like I've had to like vent a lot. Long story short, I just feel like I need more out of life and I need to focus on the right things. Just kind of like maybe separate myself a little bit from the people around me. And I know it's so hard, and it's so hard on my part, but I feel like I just want to be around people who like to be around me. I feel like I'm the type of person who's always trying to reach out to people, but people never really try to reach out to me. And it kind of hurts my feelings a little bit. And I feel like I do kind of that to myself. You know, I just want to focus on myself. And I know it's going to be really, really hard, because I'm a person who likes to go out and just kind of like everything goes out the door when it's time to go out and get my mind off of things. Because you guys know I do suffer from anxiety and depressive episodes. And it's really, really hard for me sometimes to even want to just do anything or talk to anyone. I want to be better. I want to do better, and I want to become better, and I know I can. And also same thing goes with my body. I haven't really been taking care of my body the way that I should, and I need to take better care of her, and I need to get into better shape, because I am starting to kind of get comfortable again in where I'm at, and that's not right. I just know that I can look better, and I can also feel better when I look better. Probably this rant was kind of annoying for some of you guys. I'm gonna go inside and start on my Trader Joe's haul, but you know, we want to do better. It's officially summer, is it? Is it hot girl summer? I don't even want to call it hot girl summer. I want to call it like prospering hot girl summer. Like hot spiritual girl summer. Becoming a better bitch summer. Just becoming a better person hot girl summer. I don't know. We gotta do better, baby. Me talking to me. We have to do better. We have to become better.
So here is my little Trader Joe's haul. It's very small. I spent like $65. Now I'm like, where the hell did the $65 go? But it's fine. I haven't done a Trader Joe's haul in a really, really long time. So this is mostly low carb, kind of keto friendly, a little more towards the low carb, just because that's what I've been liking recently. I've still been able to lose weight that way and still be able to kind of keep it keto. I don't want to say I'm 100% keto right now, but right now I'm just focusing on making better choices and staying as low carb as possible. So to get started, I have one of my favorites. This is the rice cauliflower stir fry. It does have some corn and green peas in there if you don't mind it. It's super delicious. It's literally one of my favorite things from Trader Joe's. I got some arugula. Arugula is my favorite green. It's so delicious. It's either a love or hate relationship that you have with arugula, but mine is definitely a love. I love it on everything. I love making little salads as a side or putting it on my eggs or sandwiches. Literally, I'm obsessed with arugula. I have some fresh berries, raspberries, strawberries. I got some little mini cucumbers because I want to make, I've seen a lot of like spicy cucumber salads on my feed on TikTok, so I wanted to try that. I also got some baby carrots. I know, not the keto-est friendly thing ever. I know people go crazy about it, but I genuinely like it as a snack, and it is a healthy snack, and I like it. You just have to be careful with your macros and such. I also got these unsweetened acai packets because I love my acai bowls. They're so freaking delicious and so yummy. And I also got these because recently I've been on a really fruity kick. I think one of the things that have been the hardest for me being on keto is like the fruits and the sour, sweet things like that. So I got these on days where my carb count is low, or if I just, you know, keep it super, super low. Now, basically, I like to stay in between 20 to 30 net carbs. So these are 45 calories per pouch and 10 net carbs, which isn't the greatest, but you can definitely make it work. So on days where my carb count is a little lower, I can have these as a treat when I'm craving something fruity. So these are organic apple fruit sauce crushers. There was also one that was apple strawberry that was 9 net carbs, but I'm not really I just wanted just straight apple. So I just got the apple one. I got some fresh mozzarella cheese because I love to have that also as a snack or as a side with some tomato and some balsamic vinegar. I got these. I think this is what made it expensive. These are like $11, this bag of shrimp. So these shrimp, if you guys follow Keeping Up with the Keto-dashians, they say they taste like lobster, that it's super, super good. I've seen them talk about this shrimp literally since I started doing keto like 2 years ago, and I just had to get them because I was in the mood for some shrimp and they always recommend it. And I'm like, you know what? Let me get it. I got my favorite almonds ever. I can literally finish these in one sitting. These are the Marcona, is that how you say it? Marcona almonds with rosemary, and they're roasted and salted. These are delicious. These with some fresh mozzarella on the side and some like salami or something is an amazing snack, and it's so filling. These are so great if you're going to the beach or to the pool, especially now that it's summer. You take some of these and some berries and stuff, and it's so good. Definitely try them. I think there's another flavor of these, but I don't remember. I feel like I have tried it, but I always go back to these. And these kind of taste like cashews more than almonds. These are Marcona almonds. I don't really know what the difference is, but I mean, they're still super yummy, and they remind me of cashews because I know cashews used to be my favorite. Well, no, cashews are my favorite nut, but I want to say Marcona almonds have become my favorite because it's literally an in-between of cashews and almonds, and they're so freaking, these are so good. They're a little expensive. They're almost $6, but they're so worth it because they're so delicious. I got some avocados, some avocado oil spray. I find that this helps me a lot, especially because we tend to forget how many calories is in oils like avocado oil, olive oil, and all that. Like, it's almost like 100 calories per tablespoon. Is that what it is? So sometimes I'm a person who used to overuse oil, like forgetting that there was calories in oils. So this helps because this is like all zero everything. So I use this to cook my meats and stuff instead of using like pure avocado oil. I just use this better just because I can control it more than using pure avocado oil, because that way you can go up your calories a lot. I got this seasoning over here. I'm not gonna say it because I don't wanna say it wrong and sound like an idiot, but I've seen people use this all the time. So it's 25 calories and 1 net carb per tablespoon. So it's like seaweed and sesame seeds. So there's white sesame seeds, black sesame seeds, nori, which is seaweed, salt, and kelp powder. And I've seen people put this in basically everything, in their cauliflower rice, on their eggs, and I love seaweed and everything. Sesame seeds and stuff like that. So I finally saw it. I don't know why, the times that I've gone to my Trader Joe's, I've never seen this. So when I saw it today, I'm like, I'm gonna pick these up. I also got these cauliflower thins. I know these have been around for a really, really long time, but I've never seen them at my Trader Joe's, and now I see why. Where they have them is like all the way like in a corner, and I see now that they have a pizza crust, but I wanted to try this better. I've seen people use this like for sandwiches and stuff, and even make little mini pizzas. I'm not a huge cauliflower fan, but I wanted to give these a try because I've been seeing them pop up on my keto Instagram page a lot. So we're gonna give these a try. Let me know how you guys like to have them. So it's two, so per, oh my goodness. So it's for two pieces, it's 100 calories and one net carb. Wow. Wow, that's great actually. What? Damn, that's cool. Hopefully they taste good as they look. And then lastly, okay, so this is the fun stuff that I got because I will be going back. Okay, let's talk about this. So as you guys know, like I talked about in the car, I do want to start making better choices for my body and my meals and all that stuff. Kind of try to be a little cleaner. As much as I love coming up with low carb keto recipes, sometimes they are not the cleanest and they're not the best to have every single day. As much as those are so much fun and I love coming up with them, I kind of just want to make better decisions for myself and kind of focus more on just like basic recipes, still delicious recipes, but just try to focus on cleaner ingredients and cleaner things, you know what I mean? Tomorrow, because my mom did get back home from Colombia today, so she brought back some goodies, and you guys, I'm not gonna say no to goodies, straight from Colombia. So tomorrow is when I will be using all of these. So today I wanted to kind of make some TikToks and buy some things that TikTok kind of made me buy from Trader Joe's before I go into a full health mode, to better choices mode, to better choices for Michelle mode. So first thing I got, I didn't even really like, to be honest. So these, I have been lately on this mango chamoy tahini kick. I've been craving it literally like almost every single day for like the past month. So I've always seen people buy these and I've always wanted to know what they taste like. And I got it and I don't really like it. I've never tried dried fruit. And if I have, it's been like in trail mixes where it's very, very small. But I think I'd give this like a solid, maybe 5 out of 10, 6 out of 10. It didn't really give me what I was wanting. And I don't know, half a cup, 140 calories and 32 grams of carbs and 26 grams of sugar. Not my favorite. I don't know who I'm gonna give these to. Maybe I'll give it to one of my friends or something, but I don't think I'll be having this again. But I tried it and now I know, because every time that I've gone to Trader Joe's, I always wonder and think, what the hell do these taste like? Do these taste good? I've seen people eat them and they love it. And I'm just like, no, I'm not a fan. I had to do it. I had to do it. I had to get the soup dumplings. You guys know it's been all over freaking TikTok and it drives me crazy because I'm like, I have to try these, but when am I gonna go to Trader Joe's? So I thought today's the perfect day, and if I'm gonna go, I need to try these. I need to try these. So for the whole pack, it's 270 calories and 29 grams of carbs. I wouldn't say it's terrible for a whole pack. So I'm gonna try these a little later. I'm gonna do this on camera with you guys. And then I also got these. These are like $2. Like $2.50, I wanna say. So these are chicken cilantro mini wontons. I've also seen people make these with the chili oil. I don't know if you guys see it over there. No, my hand is focusing. The chili oil, you know, let me show you. And I've seen a whole bunch of people eat the dumplings and all that stuff from Trader Joe's with the chili onion crunch oil, and it's so delicious. This tastes so good, you guys. This on anything tastes super good. So I got the dumplings basically because I've seen a whole bunch of people on TikTok eat it that way, so I wanted to try it. And also, and the macros for these are not that bad. For four pieces, it's 8 net carbs and 50 calories. 50 calories for 4 wontons, dumpling things. So yeah, we're gonna try those later for dinner. We're gonna try both of these. And yeah, this I'll probably give it to my dad. I feel like he'd like this, but this I'm not a fan of. This I'm excited for. I'm very, very excited for. So yeah, here was my little mini grocery haul, my little Trader Joe's grocery haul. Like I said, I wanna keep it as basic as I can and just trying to make better choices for myself. Hi guys, so I totally forgot to record me trying the viral TikTok Trader Joe's steamed pork dumplings. Everyone talks about how they like the chicken one better, but at my Trader Joe's, they only had the pork. I filmed 2 TikToks, so go and follow me on TikTok to see what I thought about them. My first ever TikTok eating show thing. I don't know about you guys, but I love watching TikTokers like eat. I've noticed that most of the new people that I follow on TikTok are just random people who just eat every day, like eat on their lunch break and just talk about anything about their day and they're just eating. Those are my favorite TikToks right now. Oh, and the Adult Swim trend videos. Yeah, so those two have been my comfort TikToks right now. But yeah, if you guys wanna see, go check out my TikTok and you guys will find it there. No, I was gonna tell you what I feel about them, but I want you guys to go follow me on TikTok because I'm trying to be on my TikTok game. You know? Good morning, everyone. So, like, you know me, I forgot to do an outro again. Yesterday was just one of those days where I had a million things to do and it wasn't really all that exciting. I think the last time I left you guys was when I told you guys that I was trying the soup dumplings, but I forgot to record it, so you guys have to go check it out on my TikTok. And yeah, that was basically it for the entire day. Maybe I had like a snack at night, and yeah, my day was pretty boring yesterday. I just wanted to bring you guys along with me to update you guys on everything. I'm actually gonna start filming right now for my next video, so I'm not really gonna talk all that much today. Well, right now this is just gonna be the outro, and yeah, I hope you guys have an amazing day whenever you see this. I don't know if this will be today is Wednesday, and I'm going to go and edit this right now so then I can have it up for you guys today. So I hope you guys have a great rest of your day. I will see you guys either tomorrow or Friday for my next video. I'm gonna go for tomorrow. And yeah, if you guys like this video, make sure to give it a big thumbs up. Subscribe down below for more videos every single week. Make sure to follow me on all my social medias. I'm on Snapchat, Twitter, Instagram, TikTok, and OnlyFans. I am currently running another 50% off on OnlyFans for $7.50. Do not miss out on that one. I love you guys so much. Always remember to be kind to one another, and I'll see you on my next one. Mwah.